Hello and welcome to TV30, a production of the Government Information Service. My name is Jessie Leonce, Information Assistant at the Department of Sustainable Development. The Caribbean Cooperative MRV Hub, that is Measurement, Reporting and Verification Hub 2023 annual meeting and the Biennial Transparency Report BTR Work Plan Workshop will be held in St. Lucia next week. And in studio with me to speak a little bit about that activity, those activities, as well as a little bit more about the MRV Hub in particular, is Ms. Benice Joseph, representing the MRV Hub here on island. Good day to you, Ms. Joseph. Thank you so much for joining me.
Thank you, Jesse, for having me.
Wonderful. So before we get into the events, if you, for the benefit of our viewers, could just give us an understanding of what the Caribbean Cooperative MRV Hub, or Measurement, Reporting and Verification Hub, is all about and how it applies to its participating countries.
Okay, thanks, Jesse. So the Caribbean Cooperative Measurement, Reporting and Verification Hub, or MRV for short, is an organization that has been developed over the past 5 years. So we received a grant from the German government to support 12 member English-speaking countries, Caribbean countries that is, to help them with guidance, training and capacity building as it pertains to carbon accounting, modeling and projections, and other stuff related to greenhouse gas emissions. And so that's what we do at the Caribbean Cooperative MRV Hub. We have a team of experts that help the 12 member countries, going from Bahamas all the way down to Guyana, the English-speaking Caribbean, with their greenhouse gas inventories, with their reporting requirements as it pertains to the United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change, or UNFCCC.
Wonderful. And so when we hear information about measuring, research in general, reporting, verification, that information is usually for the technical mind. But if you could break it down for us and help us to understand how these modalities, how these modes of research and so on can be applied to various sectors, various causes that St. Lucia is currently involved in.
Okay, thanks, Jesse. Let me see if I can do that to the best of my abilities. So with measurement and reporting and verification, what we do at the Caribbean Cooperative Hub, we more or less, countries have been doing it all along. So countries have been doing their inventories over the past few years. St. Lucia, for example, has done 4 inventories so far. That's greenhouse gas inventories. What has happened now with the Paris Agreement, and I think we all know about the Paris Agreement, we have more reporting requirements. So we're now required to do our inventories every 2 years. And so that would put a strain on the human resources of the countries in the region. And so that's where the hub comes in place. We've developed a team of Caribbean experts who have the knowledge, the understanding of the national circumstances in the various countries. And so they're helping the countries develop their greenhouse gas inventories to assist in data collection and modeling and projections as it pertains to our nationally determined contribution, which is our NDCs that all countries have to submit as part of the Paris Agreement. With measurement, we more do data collection. Mm-hmm. And so we support countries in understanding what data is required to be able to do the accounting itself. So for example, we do estimation of emissions for the energy sector, which includes energy generation, the transport sector. We need to collect data on the various aspects of the transport services to see what kind of emissions are being released per country in the region to meet our reporting requirements. So these are some of the things we help the countries with. We provide them with guidance documents. We support them in their know-how. We do trainings on workshops and invite the technical experts in the countries to join in those workshops and understand all the requirements that need to be met as part of the new Paris Agreement
that's been put in place.
Yeah.
Okay, so looking at, well, since the Paris Agreement, speak to us about the input that has been provided to and the support that has been provided to St. Lucia specifically through the MRV Hub. We know that there are several projects ongoing. You spoke to the nationally determined contributions. Speak to the value specifically that it has had, the resource support that has been provided has had for St. Lucia.
Okay, so with the establishment of the MRV Hub, St. Lucia has benefited greatly with that organization. So we've had a number of our technical experts in the government of St. Lucia be trained in the different areas for the greenhouse gas inventories. So you have areas such as energy, you have the industrial processes and product use, you have agriculture, you have waste, and you have land use change and forestry, or more or less the forestry area. Mm-hmm. So we've had a number of our technical experts in the government of St. Lucia trained in those areas, and a lot of them are now on the UNFCCC website as listed as experts in the region. And so they can go on, do reviews for other countries, develop themselves even further. And so what the hub is there to do is to build up that capacity within not only St. Lucia, I know Jesse said about just focus on St. Lucia, mm-hmm. but within the Caribbean, and mm-hmm. also help the Caribbean technical experts share best practices, share lessons learned, because mm-hmm. although we know that we have differences among the Caribbean, but we do have similarities as well. So it's important that we share those lessons learned, share our mistakes, the obstacles that we face, because sometimes, most of the time, they're almost the same obstacles that are faced in most of the countries.
Okay, wonderful. So speak to the significance of having, the benefit of having in a cultural context of having St. Lucian experts, having Caribbean experts being able to test, research, look at the information that they're getting from St. Lucia in terms of, as you indicated, emissions and what have you, and be able to make determinations from that.
Okay, so a lot of our countries, in the region, we've hired consultants from overseas to come in to do our estimations for us, because most times they have the knowledge and the know-how. Building up our Caribbean experts, we more or less mitigate the area where we have to explain to them our national circumstances. We have to explain to them what goes on in the country. We have to explain to them what kind of data we collect. Why is it difficult for us to get some of the data? What are the attitudes of the people in the region, and why it is that people do certain things that they do? How does the government of the government services function in the region? So all these aspects we as Caribbean experts, we have that knowledge, mm-hmm. and so that it makes it easier. So for example, just explaining to a foreigner how our bus systems work is a difficult task all by itself. Having experts in the region who are able to write it, to explain it on paper to the international forum, that this is what goes on in our country, this is how we operate, this is what we think is best for our country as well. And mm-hmm. it also helps you to define policies that are relevant to the countries, and not policies that are just copied or pasted from mm-hmm. European or American states. So it's our own developing our own expertise in more or less a sense.
Okay, wonderful. What is the latest news coming from the MRV Hub? I know we're coming to the annual meeting and a little bit about the workshop happening in St. Lucia next week, but what else is outstanding in terms of achievements, milestones, particularly in 2023?
Okay, so in 2023, the MRV Hub is actually coming to the end of its grant. So we're establishing the organization, because as part of the grant, we're supposed to establish an organization with an aspect of sustainability. In all of this, we also have a number of programs going on. So we do have our Summer Academy, which we've had for the past 3 or 4 years, I believe, mm-hmm. where we train, as I said, we train experts in government on greenhouse gas inventories, we are now extending it to the private sector because we believe that involving the private sector is just as important as the government workers. Having the private sector understand what's going on, having the general public understand what is going on, what is required from the government service, well, the government officers to report in those areas, what is COP all about? Why do we make such a fuss for climate change? This is why it's important to bring in as many people as possible. So we have involved the private sector in our summer academy that's coming up. In addition, with the modeling and projections program, which I lead or head, we have a webinar series coming up, starting from May 24th, going till June 28th, where we introduce different tools to the Caribbean. So we introduce different modeling and projections tools that the technical officers can use. We've brought on the developers for the different tools, and they will be speaking about the different tools and areas where they can help the technical experts in the countries develop those areas. And we, as the Caribbean Cooperative Measurement Reporting and Verification Hub, we stand in the background to support the countries in whatever area that they need. In addition to all of this, we've developed a number of guidance documents. So guidance documents, they're basically reports or documents to guide technical officers on how to collect certain data, how to do certain reporting, how to do certain analysis. So we've developed a number of guidance documents related to the waste sector, related to data collection for different tools for modeling and projections, related to transport, the transport sector as well in developing the emissions. So that's what the MRV Hub is all about, building capacity in the region, ensuring that we have the technical experts, because it's a continuation of building capacity. It's not just one expert being the know-all. We want to make sure that we in the region, we can do the necessary estimations and train others as well, because you need to maintain that sustainability. Every 2 years is not an easy task. We have people moving on, going to universities, going on to further jobs. It's important that we continually build our capacity and be able to keep meeting our requirements to the international forum.
Okay, we are speaking to Ms. Benice Joseph from the MRV Hub, and we are talking all about monitoring, reporting, and verification, reporting and verification hub, as well as the events that will be happening next week here in St. Lucia from the 24th to the 27th of April here on island. And you mentioned that the project is coming to an end, but will it really be the end? So we are due for a break. When we come back, we hear more from Benice.
The world's climate is changing, and that affects all of us. Storms are becoming increasingly intense. Periods of intense drought and heavy rain stress farm animals and destroy our crops. Higher average ocean temperatures kill our coral reefs and change the migratory patterns of fish. St. Lucia contributes only 0.0015% of global greenhouse gas emissions, but is doing its part, along with countries around the world, to reduce the emissions that are warming our world and changing our climate. These efforts are called mitigation. But decades of emissions have already changed the climate, and the greenhouse gases in the atmosphere today will increase average global temperatures even more. We need to adapt, that is, do everything we can to prepare for and respond to the actual and expected negative effects of climate change, and everyone has a role to play. We need to protect our crops, build homes that withstand storms, and keep our drains and waterways free of garbage to help us recover or bounce back from climatic events. Learn more about the Government of St. Lucia's National Adaptation Plan and the steps you can take to protect yourself and your fellow St. Lucians.
Thank you so much for staying tuned to TV 30. Next week, the 24th to the 27th of April, 2023, St. Lucia will play host to the Caribbean Cooperative MRV Hub 2023 annual meeting, as well as the Biennial Transparency Report Work Group. Plan Workshop. I'm speaking to Ms. Benice Joseph from the MRV Hub, and she has been speaking to us a little bit about the project MRV Hub, Measurement, Reporting and Verification Hub, providing expertise in those three areas for St. Lucia in being able to go forward to international agencies, making its case, being able to develop reports on its own within the region about what our particular circumstances are here in the region as it pertains to climate and other environmental matters. So, Benice, you indicated before we went to break, in speaking about the MRV Hub, that the project itself will be coming to an end. Does that mean the end of this degree of support for the participating countries?
Well, not in a sense. So with the MRV Hub, the project itself, so the funding from the German government is coming to an end. But what we hope to do is continue to support countries in their areas of capacity building. But we also, during the project, what we've gathered from countries, we've received direct contracts from countries to help with the reporting requirements as well. And so that's where the Caribbean MRV, well, the Caribbean Cooperative MRV Hub is going to continue to be there to support countries and continue building the capacity until it reaches a place where countries can do it by themselves. So part of the project was to build a sustainable organization that can continue helping countries, and this is what we've done so far.
Okay, and I would imagine that this week's annual meeting would encompass that sort of transition, provide some insight into that. Speak to us a little bit about the annual meeting that's happening next week in St. Lucia, the Caribbean Cooperative MRV Hub annual meeting, the fifth annual meeting, and what it would constitute in that sense.
Okay, so the annual meeting is twofold. So we have a workshop previously to start off the annual meeting, and then we have the annual meeting itself. So I can speak to the workshop first and then talk about the annual meeting, which is the following 2 days. Mm-hmm. So the first 2 days is the workshop where we have training on biennial transparency work plan. So what countries are doing, they're moving from a biennial update report to a biennial transparency report, which is under the Paris Agreement. And so this workshop is going to help countries develop that work plan in time for the reporting requirements for the BTR. So that's where we have training, continuing our capacity building and helping with technical officers develop that capacity. And we're working directly with another organization. And so this is going to happen on Monday and Tuesday.
How do the two reports differ?
So the biennial update report was previously under the UNFCCC convention, mm-hmm. and it had GHG inventories, mm-hmm. mitigation assessment, and other aspects involved in it. Mm-hmm. In the biennial transparency report, countries are now required to basically report on the updates for the nationally determined contribution. So what have you done? Where have you reached for your national determined contribution? In addition to that, they do have to report on the greenhouse gas inventories. And also there's some aspects on adaptation where countries have to report on. So it's an all-encompassing report, which is different to the previous biennial update report.
Understood. So that would take up the workshop component.
Yes. So that's a workshop component. We're using a tool that has been developed by PATPA and FAO. And so they will be using, we will be supporting countries whilst they help use that tool, develop themselves, and be able to develop that work plan in time for the biennial transparency report requirement dates, which begins in 2024.
Okay, understood. And then the annual meeting, tell us about that.
And so the annual meeting is our fifth annual meeting, and every year we bring in all our technical, well, our representatives from the different countries, the technical officers that we've been dealing with in the different countries. We do have, a steering committee that's representative of the different countries as well. The steering committee basically guides the MRV Hub in the work that they have to do. So the MRV Hub doesn't work on itself. We're guided by countries. The countries guide us on where they need help, where they need us to work in. And so that's where the steering committee comes in. So this annual meeting, it's about sharing what we've done, more or less what we're doing here. Mm-hmm. So we're going to be sharing what the hub has done so far with our country partners, what we've done over in the region, what is to come in the next coming months and in the next years, and how do we move forward and how do we transition to an organization without the grant support that we've been receiving over the past 5 years. So this is what the annual meeting is about. It's also an opportunity for countries to share best practices, to share lessons learned, and to meet each other as well, because we work in silos, we work virtually most of the time, and especially since COVID, it's good to get out and to meet your counterparts in the other countries as well. With the annual meeting, in addition, what we try to do is it's an area where we can get direct feedback. So not only just hosting a virtual meeting, but we have country representatives right there in person, and they tell us where they need help, where they want us to work. So we're guided by them as well. So we provide guidance, but the guidance is provided by the countries to provide guidance to the countries.
Yeah, absolutely. And speak to us a little bit about that. What are some of the support systems that are required? I mean, overall, you provide a cadre of services, but speak to us about what the participating countries usually require of the MRV Hub.
So, thanks, Jesse, again. With the countries, most of the times what we get feedback on is that the human resources, we are small islands, we very much lack human resources, and that's where the most countries need the support. The additional human resource, the additional guidance on what it is that is required by the international organizations. This is where countries usually ask the MRV Hub to provide that support. In addition to this, the MRV Hub is also providing support in terms of being able to store data. Countries have access to the data that's readily available to them. We do have an issue where data is sometimes lost in our small island developing states. It could be that it's not properly stored. It could be that we've had a hurricane that has destroyed everything. So the MRV Hub is more like a backstop in that sense, where we provide that support to countries as well. And further on, we do help them understand what is required in the reports and how. Sometimes you do all those technical analysis and you see those documents and probably you're not able to understand what's in the document itself. So that's where we come in to try to explain to the countries what is it that you're looking for, how to assess some of those the work that's been done by different consultants over the area. So that's where we are providing guidance to the countries. Okay. In these different areas.
Wonderful. Just diving a little bit deeper into the annual meeting, any experts, anybody coming in to engage, any notable figures?
We do have, so the Caribbean Cooperative MRV Hub is funded by the German government, but we do have three other partners. So we have the Greenhouse Gas Management Institute, and we have the UNFCCC Regional Climate Change Office that's in Grenada. And we have the WINDREF, which is hosted in Grenada as well. And so with these three agencies, we do have Michael Gillenwater, who's the executive director of the Greenhouse Gas Management Institute. He will be coming into for this meeting. We have Myra Santelia, I believe that's the name. She will be coming into that meeting as well. She is the representative from the UNFCCC at the regional office. Okay. We do have representatives from the Organization of Eastern Caribbean States joining our meeting. We have our program director, Wiley Barber, who's coming in to support the meeting. He's always there, and he's such a fun character to have around as well. And we have Carlos Jesus, who's from PATPA, who's going to be supporting with the first 2 days of the workshop as well. We do have other persons coming in from Greenhouse Gas Management Institute to more or less lend support and help out with the overall organization of the workshops.
Okay, wonderful. I want to touch a little bit on some of the lessons that have been learned just coming out of being able to receive this degree of support from the MRV Hub. Speak to us a little bit about how much better equipped, how far the participating countries have come since the impact of the MRV Hub in the region. And also looking at some of the requirements that are at the UNFCCC level, looking at the Paris Agreement, the requirements for data research are increasing, particularly with every single negotiation that happens, there comes you need to prove it. You need to prove what you're trying to negotiate for. So speak to us about the significance of that.
Thanks, Jesse. And I think that's a wonderful, that question is an excellent question. In terms of data and understanding the importance of data, how we can get the data, how we can fill in the data gaps that we have as well. The Caribbean Corp, the MRV Hub has been able to help countries significantly in that area. And we have countries coming back and asking for support. So once you do a good job, people usually come back and ask for support. So that's what we have happening with the MRV Hub. So we have countries requesting that kind of service from the MRV Hub to help in understanding the data, storing that data, and having that data in a useful way as well. Some of the other trainings that we've done, just to mention some of them. So for example, for the modeling and projections program, we've introduced an asynchronous training where persons are able to learn the software and do it on their own time, with their own, at their own pace as well. And what we've found that we've had over 80% of the completion rate were women. And normally in the energy sector, in modeling, in that technical area, you don't find a lot of women engaging in that area. And so it's just been tremendous, I guess we've been proud of the fact that we can actually reach that demographic, because you find that sometimes women with children, they want to be able to do work on their own. They probably don't have time to come to a workshop, or you have a series going on. These are the aspects that the MRV Hub has been able to delve in. So understanding what's going on in the region, understanding how to program our training to fit our people in the region, how their schedules are, what they do. And this is extremely important, and we've been having success rate on the different levels, extraordinary levels related to that.
Wonderful. Thank you very much, Benice Joseph. It's all the time we have for now. Benice Joseph from the MRV Hub speaking to us about the upcoming Caribbean Cooperative MRV Hub annual meeting that will be taking place here in St. Lucia. And it will be preceded by the workshop, that's the Biennial Transparency Report workshop that will be happening on island, bringing together the participating countries here under one roof on island in St. Lucia from the 24th to the 27th of April, 2023. My name is Jessie Leonce. It has been a pleasure speaking and getting a little bit more information from you on what will be transpiring this regional activity next week in St. Lucia. Do stay tuned for more programming on NTN. It's all the time we have for now. Goodbye. Thank you.